I wonder what my thumbnail for this video reaction should be. Let me think.
Well, space fans, exciting news, huh? And there's even more in part two.
Hello, this is your television speaking. Let's push the button marked idiot and see what comes out.
So the Oscars happened. I didn't watch anything, but I heard a few results. Today I'm actually going to be watching All Quiet on the Western Front. Really, really looking forward to seeing that film. Michelle Yeoh, I've always liked her. I love this woman for the longest time. She's not always the greatest actress when it comes to Hollywood fare, like television. Well, we've seen The Witcher Blood Origin, right? We know how bad that was. And even her presence couldn't lift that vehicle off the floor, could it? I mean, that thing was already a Trojan horse rolling into a sea of flames. Do Trojan horses roll? I guess they do, don't they? But she won the Best Actress Oscar, so spoiler alert if you didn't want to know that, but I guess you do now. But here's what she said to the BBC a few hours ago.
Community of Asians coming forward and saying, you're going to do this for us. You have to do this for us. You will do this for us. And then you go like, oh my God, this is really... And you go, yes, I will do my utmost.
So the thing is, look, Everything Everywhere All at Once is a really, really fun film. I'm probably going to watch it again, actually. And the thing is, you know, when she got the Oscar, Yo was still standing there saying, I hope I can give hope to other people who look like me, who can one day be here in my place and accept an Oscar for a best performance. And it's like, oh my God, Mish, just get an Oscar because you were fantastic in a movie. On your merits, not because you're the first Asian to get an Oscar ever. And I guess that's why she got the award, right? Because, hey, that's what it's all about now. Now, the reason why I mention this, because not long after, guess what? Disney have dropped the full-blown trailer for The Little Mermaid. Now, this is the official Disney Studios channel. I don't know if they're going to block reactions again like they did with... What was the one they did the reaction for recently and they blocked it? Oh, yeah, that's right, yeah. Peter Pan and Wendy. Can't wait for that one. But at the moment, 64,000 upvotes, 187,000 downvotes. So, without further ado, folks, let's watch this trailer. Let's take it back a bit.
All hands on deck! Abandon ship!
Bye, Eric. See you later, dude. And I'm guessing he's going to get rescued. Who's your mommy, Eric?
Take the code, man. Over here.
The water effects are terrible.
You
Disney 100.
He went to the Ambath world.
A man was drowning. I had to save him.
This obsession with humans has to stop.
I just want to know more about them.
Child, I can help you. You can't live in that world unless you become a human yourself.
Is that even possible?
It's what I live for.
Melissa McCarthy. Is she funny these days? I can't tell you. Oh, is that Halle Berry from the last Bond film?
Different. I can't quite figure it out.
She got legs, you idiot.
She got laid? Hang on a second. What did I just see there? Oh, look at that. There's other mermaids of color But I don't see any, I don't know, English mermaids? Scandinavian mermaids? What's going on?
He's a human, you're a mermaid.
That doesn't make us enemies.
Well, you know how you can make this a more relevant tale for today's narrative? Obviously, we know why Halle Bailey was cast in the role. Not her fault. It's obviously Disney, Victoria Alonso, Kevin Feige, as Matt Walsh likes to call him. But if you want to make this a more compelling story, maybe have Ariel turn up on the English shores as she claims asylum and then she gets persecuted and arrested. Is that too much? I guess so, actually. Yeah, I mean, it's awful. What did I say there? It's terrible. And look, there are some nice cinema bits of cinematography in the trailer. I will admit to that. Some pretty, I would say, not breathtaking. It's Rob Marshall, so he's known for getting those sort of vistas out there. But again, I didn't even click on this on purpose. It just came back up. But I think, yeah, I mean, I don't even know who this mermaid is right here. Who is that? Do I care? You know? not sure what's going on. That reminds me of Japanese anime, if you know what I'm talking about. Yeah, that's an interesting image. Look, this is not made for me. You know, I watched the 1990s cartoon. I thought it was charming. The usual Disney fare that you would expect by now. So I had no problem with that. And yeah, again, some of the hair effects just look terrible. The water effects look awful. And you know what? It kind of begs the question, if they cast, the correct actress in terms of the representation of the cartoon character and the book that it derives from, would people go and see this more? Maybe. I'd probably go and watch it. But because of the virtue signaling I see here from Disney, it's always in your face. Again, Michelle Yeoh and probably the whole of last night's Oscars will probably want to remind you that as well. I just want to show you this thing very quickly. Oh, and by the way, I went to Matt Ramos's channel to see if he did a review and or a reaction video. He hasn't done one, which I thought was hilarious. Instead, on Twitter, he just posted this and he's still... Oh, my God. God, this guy's hilarious, honestly. He had this picture of... he had the trailer for The Little Mermaid, and I just said to him in my response, looking forward to your over-the-top reaction, Matt, because they always give me a few chuckles, and it's true, they actually do. He's an actor! Is he really? He's good at acting the fool, I suppose. But if we go to Entertainment Tonight... Okay, big subscribership, nearly 6 million, 994,000 upvotes, 2,900 downvotes. I just wanted to point out the correct statistics, folks, because I know you'd come and barrage me in the comments below. 1,000 upvotes, yay, compared to 3,500 downvotes. Boo, hiss, I know I'm terrible. Awful. And if we go to IGN, look at this. Just over 5,000 upvotes, 21,000 downvotes. What was this here? Loved a part where Ariel says, "That Terminator is out there. It can't be bargained with. It can't be reasoned with. It doesn't feel pity or remorse or fear. And it absolutely will not stop ever until you are dead. It's so stunning, so brave." So May the 26th, folks, is when The Little Mermaid comes out on a big screen near you. Are you going to be watching it? I won't be. It'll be interesting to see what kind of fallout there's going to be, because people are obviously going to be talking about various aspects of the movie. I mean, I've seen some of the cringy thumbnails out there already. People just grimacing. Is it May the 26th? Oh, it just says May the 20th. Okay, I thought it was May the 26th, but... Yeah, it'll be interesting what angle of the narrative they're going to go for with the reactions to this trailer. And again, you know, Halle Bailey, yeah, I think she's going to get completely crucified for the wrong reasons. She's going to do the whole Ingram Moses narrative where she claims she's going to be getting threats and stuff on DMs, and you know, that shouldn't happen at all, but that's going to be the narrative that they play. And you know, Disney have a lot to make up for, and Marvel also as well, and no one's buying anything of it. So guys, if you enjoyed my subdued reaction to the Little Mermaid trailer, which dropped 10 hours ago, make sure you'll get your fishy towel out, wiggle it around a little bit, slap that subscribe button, hit the like button, and if I were you, and if you were me, you better join me for some tea on the next video. What did I say, tea? I'm a coffee guy.
Well, it looks as though you and your boyfriend are in for a really dirty weekend.
You are awful, but I like you.